Hey guys, what's up, Obvious? Having a great day. My name is Hadith. And today we're doing some Skype-less RBGs. This time featuring Eye of the Storm, which is one of those BGs that you have to just fight for a flag in the middle. And the winner of the mid-fight or a ninja cap usually gets to win the game. Now we're fighting a pretty semi-decent team. 1900 is usually 2200 because of the rating escalation. But we should be able to beat this team. So right now, they're just popping all our cooldowns, and we're popping cooldowns back to defend us ourselves. And the paladin used bubble, which is huge. Our paladin has, I'm getting the deep freeze. I'm parking him. Paladins are actually pretty susceptible in RBGs, just because of the fact that if somebody goes at him without a bubble, they're in a lot of trouble. So right now I just pop tree form right now, and I'm just trying to keep my team up as best as I can. And let's see. Usually healers are the one who get the flag. You don't want DPS trying to. Whoa. Okay, we're good. That was pretty late. Drain our runes. That's not us, right? Nope. That means that they got a pretty late cap. Which means that we're ahead. So in the case of never wiping anybody, that means that we should get the victory because we capped the two bases first. So usually what people do in this PG is fight middle, and if you're fighting middle and don't see any progress, oh god, Gob is in trouble. He's about to die. And if you don't see any progress, then depending on the team who's losing, or whoever wants to take the initiative, they go for a ninja cap, usually with a stealth class, like a rogue, like a druid. Just like a class like that. Rogue mage is probably the best hit squad. And if you get a third cap, then it gets dangerous for the other team. Because once you get three caps in Eye of the Storm, you lose or win a lot of rating really fast. So it's pretty much like a time bomb. The Sneak is getting owned. Okay, we're good. I just know that I missed a lot of healing because I didn't plant my mushroom. That's one of the things that I need to get used to, so. It's like in huge fights, just plant my mushroom because of the Swift Mint. That's a really cool feature now, that you can put your Swift Mint in the middle, and then just proceed to own it up with heals. Right now, it looks like the were-weapon. I'm gonna try to push up and try to knock the priest down. Nope, I didn't make it. Typhoon has like a lag now. I just built a paladin. Healing him up. Palisio is actually pretty good if they're untouched. They can just bomb huge heals, which is what you currently need in the game. And it seems that we're doing a pretty good job. I'm getting the poly of the paladin once I get enough mana. There we go. I'm gonna try to sneak a drink. Because I'm completely in. Druids go home this patch. It's actually a real thing. There we go. In RBGs, you gain mana really, really quick. There's not the 5-second delay or whatever, like in arenas. So you can literally catch up, get a full drink, and then come back to the fight like I did just right now. And getting drinks is sometimes the key to victory because if you don't let the enemies get some drinks, and you get some huge drinks like I just did, then you're in a huge advantage. Mm-hmm. There's not many people in middle, so I'm kind of scared that they'll decide to just form a hit squad and go for one of our bases. So I have to. Usually the druid is the one who rotates, so I have to legitimately be concerned and try to like see the HP pools of our guys, which are the rogue and mage. They're the ones guarding right now. Oh, I'm stunned. This is bad. I'm preaching my dying. I'm announcing you. Oof. Holy moly. Alright. Bash this warrior. Warrior is full bash. She probably will die. Oh no. Okay, the shaman didn't get knocked off. Knockoffs? Oh, knockoffs. I didn't say anything when I was the storm. People will sometimes also try to organize knockoffs. And knockoffs, like with, for example, like an AoE group from the Death Knight into an AoE knockoff. And right now they're probably gonna go for a ninja cap. I feel it. I feel it in my bones. Let's see. I'm trying to see what they're doing because we're about to get a cap here. I'm going for the cap actually. Somebody needs to do it. I guess we can't do it anymore because Strud is stopping us. Aw, that all our healers are feared. But they don't have any DPS on the bottom. They just rest. So like I said before, as long as they don't decide to go for a ninja cap and we keep it up in middle, we will eventually win. It'll be a long fight. Oh, and somebody got a huge knockoff there. I don't know if you guys saw it. Oh, Godfather, don't die on me. I'm going to reform. And Athlete, you are not dying either. No, we're wiping. That is not good. That is not good, my friends. We're not wiping. I think it's like both teams are wiping, I guess. And we just got a full rest. Like a rest, so we should be ahead. Let's see. We're going for a cap right now, as you see. Oh. Is our mage getting hit? Yeah, our tower is getting hit, but we have a backup there. We should be fine. They're saying healers pick up the flag, and as much as we'd love to pick up the flag, right now we're just getting AoE down, and if you get AoE down, you can't really pick up the flag at all. I'm gonna try for it. This fire alley is the one, like, where is the totem? I need to kill this totem. I'm fearful. Oh, Mugara is dying. I'm gonna go help. Oh, never mind. They wiped it. They're good. Oh. What? Oh, we got the flag. Holy, I was gonna say. I was about to be like, is this real life? So, they're all gonna go over to our priest because we got the flag first. They're going to get ready to attack. They're gonna attack the mage's base, actually. So I'm just gonna go there. Yep, here comes the warlock. Here comes the priest. Here comes the warrior. This is usually how the BG goes. If you lose the flag, you try to go for a third, or you try to go for a ninja. I'm probably gonna get feared here. Spelled priest. They're all hitting us pretty hard, but we should be able to be fine. I'm just gonna block this, even though I skinned. But the warrior wreck stormed. So I guess the block was justifiable. Whoa, don't die, priest. Holy, he died. Well then. No comments on that. It looks in metal that we would be getting the other flag, but I'm not sure yet. Our mage is getting hit really. It's getting hit pretty hard, man. I'm trying to keep him up. I'm blanketed. Mage, don't die on me. I'm going to reform. I'm feared. No, I'm stunned. Don't die on me. There we go. I'm out of stuns. I'm out of fears. So I'm able to top the mage off right here. I'm going to get the spell of the warlock. Which see, it leaves me low. But I usually do this. And what I do is I pop Ursal's Vortex. If I pop that, it's like a... It kind of mitigates the whole thing. Well, right now we're wiping this attack, and we're ahead 100 points. I don't know how middle's doing. Let's see. How is middle doing? Is Seems okay. It looks like a fight that nobody's winning. But our rogue seems to be in trouble. So I think I'm gonna go help him. I'm gonna go help him because he's about to die. And this priest is about to die too. Oh god. Stop him, please. Stop him, please. I'm almost there. Okay. That was a good thing that I came back. Jesus. Clone full. But we should be okay. Like, a munkin won't kill it. Won't kill us. Points to go, and we the victory should be ours. The pally's about to die. I'm just gonna Heart of the Wild DPS him too, just to make it quicker. He's dead. Heart of the Wild is such a good talent for offensiveness. Thank God druids have it, or else druids would be pretty boring. And this monkey is trying to run, and we're good. Gonna buff this rogue so he has some health. So right now we're at 120 points. Looks like a sizable lead. So I'm guessing we'll just battle it out in the middle, hope for no ganks or ninjas, and we should be good to go. Using the mighty Trank, even though it wasn't really needed. Chilling with the Trank here. Just gonna put my Swiftman down in the middle. That's the best spot to get it. To put it as. And it looks like they're going for an all in the middle. Hopefully try to get the flag. If they get the flag, it would be close, but I think we capped it first, like I said before in the beginning. So that will make the whole deal. It's so weird though doing Skype without doing RPGs without Skype or any communication device. I don't know. It's just weird. I've always done RPGs with communication, so I have no idea. This trend is a little bit annoying, so I'm gonna clone a trend. Hopefully it'll just. There we go. And our priest got the flag. He's getting some feathers. Angelic feathers are insane. They're honestly insane. Look at the priest. He's running almost as fast as I would with a mount. Check it out. You run for 80%. Look at that. That's unreal. And with this, we cap the flag and we're pretty much set. 70 points. So let me know in the comments down below if you guys enjoyed the Skypeless RPG. And if you would like to see more of these, just talk. Maybe I can add some Q&As into it as well, just like a drive-by Q&A. But like I said before, it's a live action, so they got the flag, dude. But thank God that we are about to win. That was a little mistake of ours, and we won. Haha, nice. That was a pretty good team too. Nice. So I hope you guys enjoyed this RPG commentary, this Skypeless RPG. Live commentary, and I'll see you guys later.